Hello everyone, Trix here, and welcome to hopefully the final part of Mario 3. I was pretty sure last time I was not going to finish this in one part, but I will try. Let's quickly get started. This one is Koopaling Confusion. I'm not too sure why it's called that, actually. It starts off like the Navy level from World 8. With the lava slash water you can still swim in, even though it's lava. Like I'm showing here. See, you can swim in lava. Luigi's a big boy. Lava doesn't hurt him. Not like it's hurting Bowser or anything. But hey, he's a turtle dragon-like thing, so he's got an advantage. And I already missed a coin. Let's go in again. This one is really tricky. You need to be really fast. Get on the crate immediately. Go back. Grab. Damn you, auto scroll. I hear fire, bro. There we go. See? They're easy. As long as you've got fire flower yourself. Right, this is where the level gets weird. There's a lot of pathways you can take, I'm pretty sure. There's two coins in here, I think. No! Why place a bullet bill blaster there? That's not fair. Okay, where were we? Let's go over here. You can obviously also go through a bottom path, as you can see there's multiple pathways. There's actually multiple boss fights here as well. This level takes you to a Koopaling fight. I believe it's Ludwig. I'm pretty sure, but if you take the bottom path, you actually already would have met with a pipe. It would have taken you to a Ludwig fight, but that one would only take one hit to kill, I believe. But we're obviously going for all the stuffs. And for all the stuffs, we need to take the top path. And there's even an e-reader coin in here. No, not there. Let's go up here. Jump. Go over here. One block platforming, gotta love it. And then here's where the e-reader coin would be. But once again, already got them all, and they do not reappear if you got all of them. Don't know why. You can only grab them once. Why did I fall all the way down here? Oh, luckily I can still jump out. I was afraid Luigi couldn't jump high enough. Hi, Ludwig. Hi. You are my boy. You know you're my boy. But you did hit me. So, that's going to be punishment points for you. Give me that wand. Alright, first level done. I know there's a lot more to show off here. No, not really. It's just another path on the bottom that's not that different. You don't really miss anything with the fake Ludwig fight. I might shove that in if I got some time to spare. Like I did with the previous part. I was nice. I actually showed off that third room that I said I wasn't going to show off. I later changed my mind. It's something that has happened a lot to me. Alright, now we've got auto-scroll to the left. That is blasphemy, game. Check out my level in Mario Maker. Going left on an auto-scroll. One of my most popular levels, actually. Really love that concept. Still really can't remember how I first came up with that idea. Really weird. I had something similar in Mario Maker 1, actually, but that was still a little bit different. Really. A 1-up in a Kaizo block. Yeah, this airship level is actually quite difficult. The auto-scroll to the left, it might seem like a normal thing, a natural thing, but the auto-scroll to the left can be really confusing, actually. Hopefully, I'll do this correctly. Whoa! Don't scare me like that, game. Scared the crap out of me. All of a sudden, beer cannon in your face. Yeah, I gotta love those times. Oh, auto scroll stops. Where are we going? Oh, this part. I don't like this part. It's confusing as hell. We're on the inside of the ship now. Yeah, that's also a thing. Thank you, Sledge Bro, for taking away my leave. I need it. You are also going to get annoying, so go away. I'm pretty sure it's to the left, actually. Final ace coin. Let's quickly look at that. Not going to make it like that, am I? Ah, come on. Arr. I can't even reach that. Never mind then. Ah, there it is. Why was I thinking what's over there? Why was I thinking? I should learn not to think. I always think the wrong things. Yeah, easy platforming. Those tricks we have seen so many times through the past in multiple games. Hi, Boom Boom. You're only one this time, luckily. It does help make you a lot easier. Done. And as you might have seen, by the way, this level ends. And by the way... this level is named. With that I mean, it is named Airship 1 and here's an Airship 2. Yes, there is a part 2. The level actually continues. Luigi's going to do the rest. See, we actually start in the very room we ended. Unlike in last level, you might try this out, but you will find out these are not here. This time they're kind enough to give us some invisible blocks, so we can continue up the pipe like we saw in the earlier level. And yes, even if you bring a flying power up to there, again, the big cannon. And another one. Like I was trying to say, if you bring a flying power up to the end of Bowser's Airship 1, you will see that pipe does not bring you anywhere. Would be a nice touch, actually, if you, even in the first level, could still go in there and still be able to continue this level. Thank you for the Starman, that makes this part a little less stressful. Even though it doesn't last too long, but still, those cannons can be quite tricky. Oh, we know this. We know how this works. I don't get scared by that. I've got my platforming skills with me. I should have left them at home. Why would I bring platforming skills to platforming levels? Way more fun to fail. Right, another interior section. It's like we're doing the Halberd before we even get to Kirby Superstar. Kind of what it feels like, doing these outside sections and doing an inside section and an outside section. No, it works. Really reminds me of Revenge of the Meta Knight in Kirby Superstar. You go through the Halberd. Whee! Man, I'm on a roll today. Let's not cheer too early, we're not done yet. See, even those things don't scare me. They're supposed to be hard. And I'm doing a duct. That was a bad idea. Man, three Fire Bros. I really think we are pro gamers at this point, if we get to this point. Even though it could technically be the first and maybe even only level you play when you go through this, because don't forget, originally all these levels were meant to be gotten through these e-reader cards you scan in, so if this is the first card you get, or possibly even the only card you get, it is possible you play this level first. Ah. I noticed stuff. Let me grab the stuff and let me grab you. I'd much rather have a leaf, actually. Boss time. And it's a Bowser. Just a random Bowser in an airship level. Really love that fact. Right, big guy, let's go. You don't scare me. This is an easy arena, actually, to battle Bowser, so... I don't foresee any troubles. Oh, timer. Timer thing. But it shouldn't run out. Mostly because levels auto-scroll, I think. Auto-scroll forces you in not being able to do things quicker than you're supposed to. Come on. I really don't like that when you have Bowser pinpointed in a position where you know he's going to jump. And then apparently you move too early and he changes the direction where he's going to ground pound you. Now I got you. Yeah, that was an accident I got hit. An accident went a little bit slower, so I was sure he was going to stay in position. And he did. Level cleared. And with that we have done every single regular level from the e-readers, because these next ones, as you can see, they say PR. These are promotional cards. These are extremely rare to get. These are the ones you couldn't get in stores. These were promotional levels. Only on certain occasions in events you were able to play these. But they were very nice when they made the Virtual Console for this game. And even those levels are put in here. And the first one is Airships Revenge. And yep, these, like I said, are extremely rare levels. It's almost impossible to find these back in the day. In fact, they were impossible to find. Unless you had some connections to some important people or important products with companies. These were made for special occasions, these levels. So even in the original version, it is very unlikely that you have played these. But even these levels are present in the Virtual Console version. Luckily they are. Here's number 3. This is their next attempt in creating an airship level. Trying to kill us. I have succeeded on occasion. Have I died on an airship level in this playthrough? Need to look that up, I'm actually not too sure. Airship levels really don't give me that much trouble normally. No, I'm pretty sure I haven't died on an airship level actually. Man, it's been so long since I've played all of these parts from the early parts of this playthrough that I've completely forgotten where I actually died. I'm pretty sure none of them were airship levels. Even in the extra content. Let's try to keep it that way. Right, that was it. We've got all the levels. Not the levels, the coins. And we get a random Morton for some reason. Who also manages to hit me. Why am I getting hit by all of these Koopalings all of a sudden? Koopalings should be easy. Unless I start using them in some very bad ideas for Mario Maker levels, like I've been doing recently. upside down koepeling fight for one. I'm going to stay with Mario because no time to dwaddle. I really, really, really don't want to do with Luigi. So, and if you are following my Mario Maker levels, then you should recognize this one because I actually recreated this one in Mario Maker. So because of this, I should know where everything is. I did miss the first coin. I missed the second one. Alright, let's try that again. Another speedrunner level. Like I promised, this is actually one that, unlike some of one earlier one we've played, this one actually is one you do get barely enough time to finish this. But let me just try this a couple of times. Yeah, this is actually hard, even for a speedrunner like me. This is actually meant to be extremely hard, so it is extremely hard. But in a few tries, I can fine-tune this level, and I will be able to get this. There we go. Yeah, I don't know what it is about speedruns. There's just something really, really fun in fine-tuning the run. Getting better every single attempt you make out of it. That's a lot of fun. Final level, by the way. Treacherous Halls. Let's see if I can find everything in here. First try, first go. Alright, let's see what we have got here. First of all, we've got these bounce off all enemies to avoid being killed by the spikes kind of thing. But it's not really that hard. It is, of course, tricky platforming. It is one space wide jumps with moving platforms, because enemies are, of course, moving platforms. What is behind here? What is behind door number two? I get this puzzle. Get rid of the coins, then wait for the P-switch to run out, and then you can go in here. Yeah. I know how puzzles work. Speaking of puzzles, P-switch puzzle number two. Grab some coins, get the P-switch, and you can get in here. Ace coin get. And of course, Luigi's platforming mechanics once again screw me over. Why wouldn't they? Would be so nice to finally say goodbye to Luigi's amazingly awful platforming in this game. Luigi always is supposed to have this weird mechanics in comparison to Mario, but it is extremely bad in this game, especially in World E. It is also present regular game. It is definitely not as bad regular game as it is here. I was pretty sure you were able to duck under that. Apparently you cannot. I really want to get rid of Luigi's awful slipperiness. Have we said hello to the flurries yet, by the way? They are a thing. More Mario 2 mechanics. They didn't quite find a place for quite yet. But here they are. Oh, of course, Luigi needs to duck when he's big, otherwise can't get through. Let's get back. I'm surprised I actually managed to land on him, actually. With Luigi's jumping mechanics, I expected a failure. Any piranha plants coming out of the pipes? No? I'm surprised, actually. Oh! Don't fool me with your stupid spiny all of a sudden. Hopping off enemies and all of a sudden, spiky enemy. You are dead. Because you can't land on spiked enemies. This does not look too friendly, actually. Let's try it. Well, at least they're not winged anymore now, so it should be easier to get here. There we go. Ah, dang it! Let Luigi's awful failing jumping mechanics be the finale of this project. Man, it would suit this project nicely to have Luigi's weird jumping mechanics be the finale. It does trip me up a lot in this final course. But we are almost done. This is it. There we go. Yeah, I can't really explain it. You do actually need to feel the way Luigi controls in order to understand what I mean. But with that, we have completed all of the courses. It was a train wreck. A train wreck that is still busy. The train is still not done collapsing. But with a lot of effort, I was able to get through it all. I know I did not really grab all of the e-reader coins, but I couldn't. So I just stood by saying where they were. In all honesty, I did not know that all of the e-reader coins stay away if you play it from a completed save file, because all the ace coins still appear. So I assumed the e-reader coins do too. The ones you see in this castle over here, because this is where you can see them all. And with the numbers beside them, you can see in which levels you can get them. That's what helps you. But that was it. I must say, this bonus content is not as much... how should I put this? The bonus content was not really what I expected it to be. I really thought it was going to be a party, me platforming and enjoying the platforming and everything. But it was a lot tougher than I remembered. In all honesty, I haven't played this too much. I haven't played the e-reader levels that often. That's probably why I failed that much as I did. I know these levels aren't easy. They're supposed to be hard, and there's probably people who die like 100 times in all of them, and they're saying, man, stop being sorry for yourself. You're an awesome platformer. I die 100 times in a level where you only die twice. But I know I can do better than this. I try to show off in platformers that platformers are my to-go games. That is my type of gaming I like the most, and I... Even if I die once, I'm already ashamed of, man, I can do better, just not me, I do these games without dying all the time, and I know me recording and talking by them is mostly the reason for them. But all with all, maybe not in the way I was in my mind trying to do it, but I did manage to get through all of them. And I even gained over 100 lives in them, so I know I shouldn't be complaining. It's just, I know I can do better than I've shown, and that probably would show if I would have picked only Mario, but Luigi, man, if you want a challenge, pick Luigi for these levels, then you get your challenge. I hope you enjoyed my complete train wreck of Super Mario Bros. 3. I know some people enjoy train wrecks, so... But anyway, this was it. Next week I will return with my next Let's Play of games I have to play 3 times. I have only one left. I know Hyrule Warriors is also a game that released 3 times, but I'm not playing that one three times. Already saying that. With that, there's only one game left I have in my possession that has released 3 times, and I have all 3 of them in my possession, and that is The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening. That's going to be my next project. See you next week. This video is long enough. Treeks out!